Greetings, Gaians. This is a small let's play of the Gaian game, SwitchEm. I am starting on level 7 since that is the one that most people seem to have the most trouble with, and it gave me a very nice starter screen, it seems. Just to set things up, one of the first things you're going to want to look for, as you can see, you have start with 40 moves. And you need to get 5,000, which means you're going to need to get about 120 points per switch. And each icon that pops is, of course, worth 20 points. So to start things off, one of the things you're going to want to look for is a switch that immediately gives you 1,000 or 120 points. Like this, pops the greens, pops the, what are those ones called? Rufuses. And that guarantees a 120 points, possibly more, but of course that's part of the random number owner, I guess. And here's one that's not only going to give me 120 due to the wing dropping here, but if you look above in this column, these wings will also drop and create another small chain, as well as the pink cat. That one is a very nice one. But you're going to want to do, especially, is look for those matches that give you more than just the initial amount. Now, if I switch this one, for example, that would drop the coin down here and give me a 4 on a next turn. But I think we might be able to do better than that, so I'm going to keep skimming over it. That would drop those. Not terribly many good options. I'm probably overlooking something major that somebody's like, oh, why aren't you doing this? I'm gonna try for a small setup, I think. If that goes there. Actually, no, that actually might be a better setup. Because I'm gonna go with that after all and then switch the coins. But that also gives me a chance to, perfect, switch these and bring those green ones. So sometimes you do have to think ahead, although I've learned that doesn't always work simply because the switches, sometimes it'll pop something you didn't expect it to and ruin a combo, so to speak, although usually that's for the better because that means you popped a combo early, which means more points in the long run. Let's see if I switch that. Another thing, and this is actually a decent point to look out for, if you are stuck and you're just not sure where to go from the next point, something, if you pop, for example, when I switch these two, it gives me a chance to maybe match these two if a green falls into this case, space, or if a coin falls onto the bottom, I might be able to pop something here. And that is decent. Usually, when you reach level 7, you want to try for something that might give you a better chance, like 3. But, nope, no match. So that one, could have been better, could have been worse. Okay, here's a good one for a 6. If I switch that, the pumpkins gives me that, and also the grannies at the top. So that one was a pretty good one. Let's see what else I can find. It's kind of tricky when you get to this particular level. I've heard a lot of other Gaians say that they can't get past level 7. And this is definitely where the no time limit and, well, mainly the no time limit comes to play, but you also gotta think ahead and look ahead and see what moves you have. Like, yeah, you could just obviously switch, oh, I could switch these here, oh, I could switch those there, but you gotta look ahead and see what will cause combos. As with most switching games like this, It just gets really tricky because sometimes, yeah, you can only switch and it'll only give you one combo when you need to be keeping an eye on those moves and the score that you need. Now, I'm in pretty good shape right now. If I got 100 points, I'm only about 200 behind if I got 100 points each of these moves. So I'm actually in pretty good shape right now, so I could go for a riskier move and one that doesn't guarantee me to get points, which I'm probably going to have to do. I just have to choose which one I want to do. Yeah, let's go with this one, because that'll line these close up so I can maybe switch these. Okay, that's not bad. I'm not terribly keen on it. However, again, if I switch these, then I'll have two pinks here that I might be able to match, and also the Rufus is at the top. If a Rufus falls in that top position, or a pink falls right there, and it's both actually nice. Here's a good example of a guaranteed, and then the greens drop. See what else I can find. So yeah, sometimes the risky moves pay off, sometimes they don't. But when it gets to level 7, there is a lot more random chance involved on when you can find switches. I'll probably be fast forwarding from this point so people can get a gameplay idea. And we'll see where it goes from there. Okay, now we're at level 11. And as you can see, yeah, added shape, lots more difficult. I really haven't any great strategy, so we only get 55 moves for 7,000 points. And yeah, one added shape ramps up the difficulty a lot. I don't really see any great starting moves. I see a couple of fives. There, that would give me five. That would only give me five, although it would set up for our next turn, depending. No, that's not very good at all. Switch there brings down Cat Pumpkin. But then those pumpkins would be gone. Switch there, that brings. Yeah, I am not liking the looks of this particular setup. But then again, that's what you get. I think I'm gonna start over here actually, because that'll line up those. Not quite what I was envisioning, but that's okay because then it gets that combo. Okay, that's not bad. Get a combo there, get a combo there. At the top that I wasn't anticipating. So yeah, level 11, I think I've managed to get past it once without the power. Well, actually I never use the power-ups, but I have bought extra moves. As it stands, I think I'm going to let this sit. Do that one now. Because then I can do this combo. Actually, that means I can do get a 6 up here. Either way, it's a lot more difficult on level 11 to get 6 bursts for 120 points each. Okay, that wouldn't be too bad. Drops the pumpkin egg. Okay, I could switch this one sideways, but I'm going to switch it up because that means the egg will line up there and give me a combo. So yeah, you may have seen me do that on a couple other points when I was going through the previous levels, but yeah, sacrificing what would be the apparent 4 for an extra 20 points. Well, either way, I'm gonna leave this up here. I'm not gonna get much further in level 11. I rarely do. And I have gotten to the end within like 500 points, but ran out of moves. If you're in it for the soul candy in this particular thing, I kind of like the revamp, I'll admit. Ooh, yay. That was a nice one. So drop that. Okay, possibility that if the pink lands here, but again, with that previous strategy of just dropping the top column within the top three and hoping that there's a match at the top. Problem comes in with this one is there's also one additional color, so the chances of getting the color you need again drop pretty dramatically. Yeah, I'm gonna stick with this one, because that lines up these gold coins and those two greens. And we'll see if maybe we can get a gold. Nope. These up though. Not gonna do that one. Yeah, I think I'll leave off here.